Hey, Janina Vella here, and welcome to Trendsetter episode 9. I'm sorry, yes, I acknowledge that it has been a while since my last Trendsetter. And explained ko sa last video ko talking about the 3 COVID tests. If you haven't watched that, you can totally check that out in the description box below. What the? Pero medyo nahirapan ako sa work from home, distance learning, mix and balance. So, I'm sorry about that, but I'm back. Alam ko na medyo late ako sa topic na to, pero hindi ko palalampasin ang panahon para i-commend ang babaeng to. I'm sure nabasa niyo yung buong serye Among Liza Soberano, Converge, and PLDT. Long story short, nag-complain si Liza dahil sa bagal ng internet ng Converge at ibinahagi niya na hindi sila sumasagot sa mga tawag ni Liza. Mabilis na nag-response si PLDT, pumunta sila sa bahay niya. I think literally the next day, they connected her to a new Wi-Fi router and gave her 300 Mbps. Siguro dahil hindi sila masaya sa nangyari, pero there was a Converge employee who divulged Liza's personal information and one who went as far as making a rape joke about her. Liza did not take this lightly, as she should, because rape jokes are not funny and they will never be funny. So she filed a case in the Quezon City Hall of Justice versus Melissa Olaes for violating the Cybercrime Prevention Act of 2012. Converge did apologize online, but it was too late because the damage had already been done. Comments and jokes that degrade women have been tolerated for way too long. Just because it's normal doesn't make it right. Nagsimula ang usapang cosmetic surgery dahil sa mga photos na nag-circulate sa internet ni Janine Berdin. Ang punto ng mga posts ay para ipakita ang bago niyang ash purple hair, which looks absolutely stunning by the way, pero iba ang naging focus ng mga internet users. Both fans and non-fans alike pointed out a noticeable change in Berdin's features. Iba-iba ang mga naging reaksyon ng mga netizens, from shaming the surgery to shaming the shamers to praising Janine, but one reaction in particular gained a lot of attention and also caused much controversy. I think we should all start normalizing cosmetic surgeries here in our country. I can still remember what y'all did to Arcy Munoz back in 2017 when she had her nose done. There's nothing wrong with cosmetic surgeries as long as you do it for yourself. Ang ganda, Janine Berdin. Let's rewind just a little bit. Noong 2017, lumabas si Arcy Munoz sa TV na may mga pagbabago sa kanyang anyo, and internet users slammed her for it. Sa isang interview, tinanong si Janine ni Miss Darla kung bakit bigla siyang naging blooming, at ito ang sagot niya.
Para naging blooming po ako kasi hindi po ako natakot of change. Mm-hmm. Like, I think that's what everyone should keep in mind na. If there's something you don't like about yourself and if you're not happy about it, then you can do something to make yourself happy.
I completely agree with the lesson that if it doesn't hurt anyone, we shouldn't shame or condemn someone for what they choose to do with their own bodies. But should going under the knife be as accepted as putting on makeup? Should cosmetic surgery be normalized in our country? What if normalizing cosmetic surgery will lead to accepting these unattainable beauty standards and Western ones at that? Will this solidify the Filipinos' need to go through lengths and jump through hoops to reach them? Kung hindi, where do we draw the line? When do we encourage the value of contentment and acceptance? Or when do we keep slicing until we reach this level of perfection? Plus, hindi lahat may kaya magbayad ng ganung halaga. Will this end up a new way of subliminal poor shaming? By the way, I'm not hating on anyone who's ever undergone cosmetic surgery. I'm sure your reasons are completely valid and I respect that. It's just that I don't want my children to grow up in a world where they feel the need to change to be as beautiful as the celebrities they see on TV. I want to be able to tell them, you're beautiful, nothing can change that, and I want them to believe it. Bago tayo mag-move sa politics section, gusto ko lang sabihin na this video is sponsored by Skillshare! Yes! May pa-sponsor na si Trendsetter, guys! Kung hindi niyo pa alam kung ano yung Skillshare, it's basically a site where you can take different kinds of online classes. They have classes from, you know, creative writing to film, photography, business, leadership, there's even productivity. Personally, gusto kong subukan yung animation classes dahil, alam niyo, from my last video, I've been really working hard on those. goes and I want to learn more. You can get a yearly subscription for less than $10 a month. Plus, the first 1,000 people to click the link in the description box can enjoy a free trial of the Skillshare Premium membership. So go ahead and click that down below. Ito yung pinaka-requested na topic for this episode at habang nire-research ko to, hindi ko mapigilang maluha. Since a few months ago, ilang beses nagtawag ang mga estudyante ng academic freeze at in-approve ni President Duterte ang recommendation na ipamove ang pagbukas ng klase from August 24 to October 5. Sabi ng DepEd, "We will use the time to make necessary adjustments and ensure all preparations have been made for the successful opening of classes for school year 2020 to 2021. Halos buwan-buwan mula ng pandemya, students have trended the hashtag academic freeze now, and it just trended again last week with students posting photos of DepEd material blunders and mistakes, and students resulting to expressing their frustration on social media by posting memes. Sabi ni Education Secretary Leonor Briones, sa pagbukas ng klase,
"Today, we celebrate a great victory. We will not allow COVID-19 to destroy our children's education and their future."
CEGP Deputy Secretary General Regina Tolentino challenged this victory, saying having a lot of students not enrolling due to inaccessible distance learning modules, with some school staffers going jobless, no victory was yet in sight. Naiintindihan ko ba yung halaga at kapangyarihan ng edukasyon? Absolutely. Mabuti ba ang intensyon ng DepEd sa pagbukas ng klase? Absolutely. Gets ko ba yung struggle ng mga students? Definitely, I'm struggling with it as well. I know our situation calls us to change the tire while the car is running, but our distance learning education system is just half-baked. It seems as if we're just not ready yet. Parang hinagis lang natin ang mga students natin sa dagat and just hoping that they'll learn how to swim. Maybe some of them will learn, but is that worth the number of students who will sink? I just think it's funny that we opened Manila Bay to protect our mental health.
I think yung pagpapasya sa mga lugar gaya ng Manila Bay na may white beach, hindi mo makakuantify ang epekto niya pagdating po sa mental health ng ating mga kababayan.
But we can't even protect the mental health of our own youth. I hope DepEd is listening, and I hope they do their best to improve their methods and systems so that we can continue to educate our students without compromising their health. We have to protect the youth's present because they are our future. Baka nakita niyo na tong mga litratong to in the midst of a pandemic when the government should be encouraging our people to stay home, the reopening of Manila Bay. Para mabigyan tayo ng context, ang Manila Bay Rehabilitation Program ay sinimulan ng Department of Environment and Natural Resources noong January 2019 bilang pagtugon sa utos ni President Duterte. Ang naaprubahang budget para sa programang ito ay tinatayang nasa 397,897,000 pesos. Dahil lumabas ang impormasyong ito sa kalagitnaan ng kinakaharap nating health and economic crisis, hindi maiiwasan questionin ng taong bayan ang mga prioridad ng gobyerno, lalo pat laman pa rin ng balita ang paglobo ng utang ng Pilipinas. Dagdag pa rito ang ilang beses ng pagbanggit ng Pangulo natin na wala na tayong pera on Monday nights when he has his addresses.
Wala na tayong pera ngayon, I would look for the money. Wala na tayong pera. Pera pang gastos. Wala na ako niyan.
So when the president signs the yearly budget, it becomes the General Appropriations Law. And so, not allocating the budget to what was signed is, you know, basically breaking the law naman. Kaya naiintindihan rin natin ang mga isinasagot ng mga opisyal regarding the timelines of the project's implementation.
Hindi naman to sinumuran ng isang linggo, ng isang buwan, o noong January. This is 2 years ago.
Kasi matagal nang naikasa at na-allocate ang budget para sa proyektong ito.
Inaprubahan po ito 2019, no? Hindi naman po natin inasahan na magkakaroon ng COVID-19, no? So, alam niyo naman, ang rule sa budget, no, kapag yan po ay nasa line item, yan lang ang po ang pwedeng paggamitan ng pondo.
In Section 25, Article 6 of the 1987 Constitution, it says, no law shall be passed authorizing the transfer of appropriations. However, the President and a lot more people may be authorized to augment any item in the general appropriations law for their respective offices from savings and other items of their respective appropriations. Basically, ang sinasabi nito ay kung may funds ka sa mga allocations na hindi nagamit, pwede mong i-reallocate sa iba. This supports a statement of Senate Minority Leader Franklin Jirlon on June 6 when he said that President Duterte may still reallocate public funds for the government's response to the COVID-19 pandemic. You know, but I can't help but wonder how many more families could have been fed. Sabi ni Vice President Lenny Robredo na if she had the funds, she would feed 80,000 more families instead of, you know, bringing Dolomite to the Manila Bay. If not food, then gadgets para sa ating mga students. Sabi ni DepEd Secretary Briones na malaking tulong sana yung pondo sa pagbili ng gadgets para sa mga last mile schools. And if not for our hungry families, if not for our students, for our frontliners na lang who need financial aid, who have been working so hard this entire pandemic. I understand that we need laws, we need policies, and we need rules to have an orderly system within our society. But great leadership prioritizes realities over rules and people over policies. Wala tayong LSS for this episode kasi gusto ko i-mention yung movie called Enola Holmes. Kung hindi nyo pa napapanood, it's on Netflix. I genuinely enjoyed it. It was so different. It was very quirky, very entertaining, not to mention empowering. I loved having a strong and a smart female lead that young kids could look up to. At kung hindi mo vibe yung Sherlock Holmes period type film, then please just watch it for this scene in particular.
Politics doesn't interest you. Why?
Because it's fatally boring.
Because you have no interest in changing a world that suits you so well.
Anyway, sana nag-enjoy kayo sa video na to. Sana may natutunan kayo. Kung may mga thoughts kayo, please leave them down below. But again, keep it kind because hate is not tolerated on this channel. Please give this video a thumbs up. Can you believe we're almost at our 10th episode? That's crazy! So subscribe kung hindi pa kayo nakasubscribe. And I will see you guys later. Let's all be a little kinder. Bye!